You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at BorisFX.com.
We've shown you how to track, but now how do we rotoscope?
We are going to show you how to create some shapes, how to track those shapes, and how to get your tracking and rotoscope data back into your host. So to get started, we want to draw a shape around this thumb and forefinger. And we want to do that because we want to make sure that we have enough data to track, but we don't necessarily need to worry about super, super detailed roto. Normally, you want to split shapes up paper doll style. I'm going to use my magnetic spline tool, and I'm going to follow this thumb and this forefinger. Now, I'm going to relax for a curve and get a nice round shape for this thumb and forefinger, just like this. And pull tight where I need any corners. So, relax for a curve, pull tight for corners. I'm going to call this finger roto. And because we're rotoscoping, we don't really need to worry about having a great track or not. We're going to let Mocha do the bulk of the motion, and then we're going to correct over time. We don't need to worry about what the surface tool is doing, because the surface tool is not something we're going to need to export for these fingers, but we are going to need to export the shape. Mocha shapes, which are normally where the track is looking, also double as roto shapes. We're going to track only translation, scale, rotation, and shear, or skew, because these properties are best for rotoscoping. Perspective can sometimes get your shape to collapse in on itself if you warp the object too much in perspective. So we're only going to track in shear. So translation, scale, rotation, and shear, or skew. If we're worried there's not going to be enough texture to track this hand when we start to go off screen, we can include parts of the hand so that when the object gets blurry, we have more detail. And now we can hit track backwards. And we can track forwards. Notice how Mocha did not stick perfectly to the object. That's because we've grouped several multiplanar objects all together into one shape. For instance, if we really wanted to have this tracked in individual pieces, we would track the front part of the finger, the back part of the finger, this thumb separately, etc. We're not going to do that because we're doing quick garbage roto for this pointer finger, and we're only going to care about where it breaks the plane of the screen. So we're going to correct our shapes where the finger breaks the plane of the screen, and we can select multiple shapes at once. We also have this cool tool where we can snap our points by hitting Alt and S, and it'll try to snap to the edges of the finger. Notice how I'm animating on the arcs of the animation. So what that means is that I'm looking for where my object is the most changed from the previous keyframes, and I'm tweening between that data. Mocha can save you time with rotoscoping by cutting down on the amount of hand animation you're having to do to correct a shape, but be aware that for complex organic objects like hands, you're still going to need a lot of keyframes, especially when motion blur is involved, like it is in this shot. Now that our shape is complete, I can save and close Mocha. Back inside of After Effects, I can create a layer new solid. For the purposes of this exercise, we're going to use this solid as our screen. You could use any image that is the same size as the tracked image, if you want to insert a screen. In my Mocha Pro plugin, I'm going to select my tracking data dropdown and hit Create Tracking Data. We're going to create tracking data from my tablet track, and this is where naming your layers comes in really handy. Hit OK. My tracking data has been created. Now I need to apply my tracking data. I would like to apply this as a corner pin that supports motion blur to my magenta solid, and apply the export. Now I have a perfectly tracked screen inside of After Effects. If I want to apply my shape data, I can duplicate my original Mocha layer
I'm going to make sure only my finger roto is visible and hit OK. Now, let's scroll to where the finger is over the screen. And let's hit Apply Mat. Now my mat is applied. I can feather this right inside the plugin. And my finger is applied directly over the top. You can also use the Create AE Masks button to create a native AE mask. All right, we talked about getting started with shapes, how the shape and the track are different, tracking and splitting shapes for roto, applying the tracking data, and applying the shape data. And now Ben Brownlee is going to walk you through Quick Start Mocha in a Continuum and Sapphire filter.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version available at BorisFX.com.